Taylor installation. Yes, yes. Yeah, and this amazing place, this amazing landscape, and a lot of dirt around me, so I'm excited to make this thing. So my work has been to construct the role of power and gender in Middle Eastern culture to address issues such as community, discrimination, identity. So I'm so interested about cultural background informed identity. And also, I'm so interested to bring to light the limitations and restrictions placed on female and their bodies, my own culture and old Middle Eastern culture. So, I'm making a set of rocks, which is this one, is the second one, and I'm going to have my third really soon. So, I already moved with the various recent movement in my country, which is called White Wednesday Movement, which is the protest against compulsory hijab, which is a law in our country that women have to wear hijab. So, what people do, they all men and women go to the street wearing something white, or some of the, those who are very, very strong and brave, taking their scarf up in the public and put themselves in trouble. So I use my own hair, usually my work, as a reference to identity, as a reminder of female body and agency, of the limit of the female body. And I use dirt as a reminder of death, mortality, beginning and the end of the culture, of the life, and our own limitations. So, and broken glasses are mostly wine and beer bottles that I'm using, some whiskey also. So many bars and what does it mean? Disposal press. Like, oh,
Greenway.
Yeah. So yeah, this is what I'm doing right now. That should be a good time. If you have any questions,
tell us about the imagery that you have here.
Yeah. The carpet is the most significant, one of the most significant things in our culture, in Iranian culture. So, I was doing the tree, which is called the coffee tree. So, I decided to not to go with the detail in the face or something like that. I'm representing the tree as a representation of life, desiring to live, and marry.
Why did you choose to use glass?
I'm using wine and glass, beer bottles. I don't point to the restriction on having beer, alcohol in my country, which we are not allowed to have it. So I'm drinking it, and I want to put it. And the glass is something like, I want to present something like desire to go, but it's dangerous to go, so it's broken and it's strong.
How do the women in your country
view about maybe in our country and differences.
It's freedom. Freedom. Everything, yeah. But it's not that in our country, everything in public is different from what you experience in your personal life.
Mm-hmm.
So believe the way that you live in here, out in the public space, but in the public.
Do you ever think of going back and showing your art in your country?
I definitely can show this art in my country. Not this, none of my most recent work. But I'm not sure if it's safe to do it or not. But if I want to do that, I need to plan something else.
So the last piece we saw, well, we didn't see, but it was going to be made of plastics and could live 400 years. This seems very, very temporary.
Yeah.
So could you talk about your motivations for creating very temporary art, or even in terms of movement? Presumably the piece we didn't see will be built here and then moved, whereas this obviously was built here, will stay here, will be destroyed here or preserved here.
Yeah.
So just talk about your motivation.
Yeah, some of my work does have a performance quality of it, so process of making it is first and second is what is coming, what is going to come up. But I will document it very well anyways during the process and also after. So I have a documentation of it. It's not for just being staying somewhere. It does, it's not made for that. Yeah. But no more questions?
Is all of the hair yours?
All the dark one are mine, but I just wanted to just use some lighter color for this part of the roots. So, these are not mine.
Whose are they?
The
hair?
Whose
is it? Whose are they?
That's one of the Iranian. I got it from my country. Yeah, I'm collecting a lot of hair right now from women who live in Iran, so it's going to be a long process. I am making a carpet. My next carpet would be made out of hair. So I'm collecting Iranian female hairs from my country. So that's going to be a long project. That's my next. And I made this scarf with hair. In progress.
How long did that take you?
I can't see. Okay.
How long did that take you to make that skirt?
This one?
Yeah.
This is not, this I just took a photo of my, when I had my hair. So I, yeah, this is not.
What's a photo of hair?
This one is kind of thing to make at least 5 years. And I asked them to give me the long, long hair. I just need that. And it wasn't successful at all. I just got little teeny hairs. But I have some people. I went there and talked to so many people. And I have some people who donate me some hair. So I'm doing it.
So the women in your country, what do they do with their hair? Do they cut it?
No, nothing culturally, no. People have it all.
Decided to build a carpet as part of your culture. Can you share a bit about carpet making and how it must have felt to build, to make your own carpet here that's somewhat different but also kind of very close to what
we're
doing at
home? One of the most important one for me is that almost 87% of black death weavers are female. So why? Because they were not allowed to go out to in the village, and they were not allowed to go because of the payment for men and women are different. We have female or male should usually go to school and study and get the better job, higher pay at, outside the home. And women are taking care of the home, all the things, and also in their free time they are doing weaving carpet. So that's one. And another one is the carpet is really popular, Persian carpet, especially in the popular. We use carpet everywhere in the home. You can have dinner on it, sleep on it, pray on it, everything.
And how long does it take to weave a carpet by hand?
It depends on how many people are working on it or how big it is.
Like the carpet this big?
For this, I think maybe a month or 2 months if two or three people are working.
Hi. We got to talk before the show and you told me about sort of the mythological symbolism behind this tree and the motif that you made, and I've been thinking a lot about it and just how beautiful this the materiality that you've given to an image that is very common in specifically in the prayer rugs as well, right? This tree, and I forget what you call the name of the tree.
Yeah, the tree that I started to work with is a talking tree or speaking tree. Yeah. Which it has the fruits are heads of female or male body, male or animals. Mm-hmm. But I understand that my most recent research was, I understand that it begins with just only female.
Just women, yeah. That's what was interesting to me when you were talking about it, and specifically that the subject matter, the materiality is all relating to that female identity in your culture and the subjugation.
Yeah.
But I wondered if you had any sort of insights as you were building, because to me these mythological motifs, they hold so much power in the process of putting our attention to them. And I just wonder, that idea, it's a very powerful image to have a tree that its fruit is severed heads or disembodied heads hanging from the branches. And just if you had any personal process or thoughts around that, or the meaning of that, or if you know more of like sort of the background of that story of why the tree had heads.
I was going to come direct to, I have my mother-in-law here, she's a singer.
Oh good.
Whenever she comes here, we try to do something to help her do something in the public. She does work, but only for women,
okay,
not in public. So that was the main thing that I want to point on that, okay. Putting have the female face open with their mouth open.
In song. So. That was how the original depiction was.
Yeah.
The fruit is producing songs.
Yeah.
Thank you.
What is the significance of the earth, the soil?
Reminder, for me, I want to point to the pressure of the all the things that I said, the female, the body, restrictions and everything. I want to point to that, and it's a reminder of death for me.
Of death.
Death.
Yeah.
Yeah. And also life.
Yeah.
So. The truth. It's like very, very unusual to sit in a format like this and have something on the ground in front of us rather than sort of on a wall. And it feels more like you. I guess, rather than a question, it's sort of like a thanks and appreciation. It feels like you made a space that we all get to sit around together and have this conversation with you. Where, you know, it's nice not to be like pointing at the thing and asking the questions about the thing instead of the other. Thank you.
Yeah.
Yeah. Is there any significance to the fact that you've used the jagged material? Is that sort of a response to the oppression in your country? I mean, it must be very hard for you to work with that.
Yeah.
Without getting cut.
Yeah. I didn't get any cut.
Wow.
It is pretty emotional. Even digging the dirt and smashing this. Yeah.
I also think like the idea that it's a prayer rug and that you bow down on it and crawl on it and it's jagged glass.
Mm-hmm.
That's what happened.
Yeah.
I
don't want to call it the prayer rock, but it can be a prayer rock. Yeah. My main, I'm happy to hear that because my main idea was producing a prayer rock. But I don't want to call it that way.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Wow.
Also, like, even without the conversation,
yeah.